One of the first questions everybody has once a deer hits the ground is, what's its score? Today we're going to teach you how to easily and accurately score any antlered or horned big game trophy in North America. Today we chose to score this awesome non-typical whitetail just to show how easy the Rackulator is to use even with abnormal points. So we turn the Rackulator on, first step it's telling me is the spread. So we're going to go the spread of the whitetail, the widest point in between the main beams. So we're going to take it like this, we're going to edge this part right to the side of the main beam and move that to the other side, just want it like that. And as soon as it's at the other side, we're going to go ahead and lock that into place. And don't worry about what the tape measure says, because the Rackulator will automatically take into account the length from the clip to the outside of the body, giving you an accurate measurement. And this part you can either feed it back in with your hand, but this is a little bit quicker way. Just run it along the table like that. Now that I've got my spread of my deer, I'm gonna press step, and that's gonna take me to circumferences. Now every whitetail deer is scored with 4 circumferences, doesn't matter if it's a 3x3 or a 10x10. Go to the circumference that the Rackulator is asking for and hook the clip back on the tape. Take the slack out and engage the lock button. Unhook the tape and insert the tape back in to the Rackulator. Once you've got your first circumference at the base, go ahead and press sub and it'll take you through your next 3 circumferences. Once you're done that, press step and it'll take you to the main beam measurement. So now that we have our 4 circumference measurements, we're gonna go ahead and take the length of the main beam. So we're gonna take our pointer, we're gonna start right at the start with a burr of the antler. We're gonna roll along the outside of it, right in the center of the antler, right to the tip of the main beam. After that, we're gonna press step, we're gonna move on to typical points. And it's actually pretty easy because the Rackulator will guide you through. So the first tine we're gonna start on is tine number 1, and that's the brow tine here. Moving on, tine 2, 3, 4, and et cetera. And how you measure these is you're gonna put the roller right to the tip and roll it down to where the tine meets the base of your main beam. Now that tine 1 is measured, we're gonna press sub to move on to tine 2. After we're done the measurements for this, we'll press sub again until all our typical tines are measured. Once you've measured all your typical tines, you can press step and move on to non-typical tines if necessary. Measuring non-typical tines is the exact same as measuring typical tines. So when the Rackulator prompts you to measure your non-typical tine, start at the tip and roll it down the tine to where it meets the main beam. In a circumstance like this where a non-typical tine can't be measured very well using the roller, it's fine to pull the tape out and use it that way. Measure the tine, engage the lock button, and then return the tape back into the Rackulator. Our left antler is all scored. We only had 1 non-typical tine, so after that I press step and it takes me to the other side. We're gonna repeat the steps on our left antler until completed to get our final score. Now that we have our left side scored, our Rackulator with a touch of a button is gonna give us our typical, non-typical, gross, and net scores for Boone and Crockett, Pope and Young, SCI, and Buckmasters. So now we got both our scores, gross and net, typical and non-typical, which takes into account all the abnormal tines. And we actually had this deer scored by an official Boone and Crockett score, and the difference between a Boone and Crockett score and the Rackulator, 2/8 of an inch. So now in just minutes, by using the Rackulator, you can have an answer for your friends when they ask, what's he score?